Hello everyone, this is Deepak Bari. Welcome to this video. Today we are going to learn and configure about the VLAN. VLAN stands for the Virtual Local Area Network. And here the quick definition of the VLAN. A virtual LAN, that is a VLAN, is a logical grouping of a network devices in the single broadcast domain. In other words, we are isolating our group of devices in a single network. Consider the following scenario, which we will do in this following example. And this is our the VLAN scenario. As you can see, we have only one switch with couple of PCs, and you can clearly see the PCs are logically grouped. Now let's understand our scenario more in depth. It starts from the VLAN 2. So VLAN 1 is reserved by default from the iOS off switch. So for this practical, we need to assign the VLAN 2 from the beginning. And this is the accounts department. And these are the following ports which will assign to the VLAN 2. And this is VLAN 3, which is for IT department. And these are the following ports. As consequently, this is the VLAN 4 and their ports, and this is the VLAN 5, which is for sales department, and these are their ports. Now let's dive in for the practical example of it. Now here, this is the file in which we will do our practical lesson. If you don't have this file, you can download from the following link I have mentioned in the below description. So just download this file simply and just open by double clicking on it. And you should see this scenario of our VLAN. As I mentioned in the description, it starts from the VLAN 2. As you know, because VLAN 1 is reserved by default, the Cisco iOS switches. And the VLAN 2, which is dedicated to the accounts department, and VLAN 3 for the IT, and VLAN 4 for the HR department, and VLAN 5 for the sales department. And now as you can see, the switches lights are turned amber to green, so that means our switcher booted successfully also here. But right now there is no configuration of VLAN in this scenario right now, so we need to first check whether all the devices ping to each other or not. So let's open a device from here. I've already configured all the IP address and assigned all the IP address in each devices. Just go to the command prompt, and this device has the IP address is 10.1 and the network is class full. So that means the 255.255.255.0 subnet, and we just need to ping from here to another device. So let's ping to the HR department, which has the IP address is 192.168.10.10. So just give the command ping 192.168.10.10. As we simply expecting, it ping successfully because there is no boundary in this network. In a networking, the device which resides within a specified network and specified subnet can ping each other. It's obvious they are connected and ping to each other. Now we need to logically isolate these devices by using VLAN. Now let's make a ping to another for checking here. Now make ping 192.168.10. Let's now ping with IT department for this PC, that is 192.168.10.9. So give the simply IP address 10.9. Now you should see the ping results here. It pinged successfully. Now what we want here, a group of devices, that means accounts department devices will ping to each other only and will not interfere to another group. So for doing this, we need to configure VLAN here in switch. So just open this switch and go to the CLI tab, and expand this. Hit the enter command and give the following commands. First, give the enable command for going to the global configuration mode from the user mode, and go to the terminal mode by typing configure terminal here. And now we will create first our VLAN and assign all the VLAN number with its name. That means we have to tell our VLAN which number of VLAN is assigned to which department or which logical group of network. So first of all, we need to give a command which is itself a VLAN, and the number of VLAN which I have told already, it starts from the number 2. So give the VLAN 2, and the name of this VLAN is accounts. So that means the VLAN 2, which has a grouping, a logically isolation, which has a name, its accounts. Now exit from here and select the VLAN 3, which resides and which belongs to IT department. So simply just give the VLAN 3, give its name, that is IT, and simply exit from here. Now the VLAN 4 and give its name, which is the HR department, name HR. Now simply exit from here, and just like others, give the VLAN 5 and the name of the VLAN, which is for sales. Now exit from here. Now we need to assign each of all ports manually by using the following commands. We need to first select which ports is belonging to which VLAN. So first we need to define which port we are going to belong to which VLAN. We need to first select all the interfaces by using this command. Interface fast Ethernet 0x1, and it will assign a VLAN 2. So we will give this command switch port access VLAN and the number of VLAN of this account department, that is the VLAN 2. Now exit from here, then select interface fast Ethernet 0x2, and this also belongs to the VLAN 2. Now consequently, I have to do these things repeatedly, so I am going firstly, you just follow these commands consequently. Now we have assigned all the accounts department pieces, that means the fast Ethernet 0x1 to 0x5 to the accounts department VLAN, that is the VLAN 2. Now we need to assign all this IT department, that is the VLAN 3, and the VLAN 4 and VLAN 5 consequently. The command should be same, just exit from here and do the same things again here also. Select the interface, which is fast Ethernet 0x6, and it has the VLAN 3. Here we have successfully assigned all the IT department computers to the VLAN 3. Now we are going to assign all the devices which resides within the HR department. Just like the same command, exit from here and select the interface, which should be interface 10, interface fast Ethernet 0x10. Now the VLAN 4 assigning is completed for the HR department. Now we are going to assign the sales department in our VLAN. So just like that, we will assign our sales department here also. Let's exit from here and select the interface. And this time the switch port access VLAN should be the 5, because the sales which resides and which belongs in the VLAN 5. Now we have completed all the VLAN assigning of our all of devices in our network. Now let's have a check of a ping, and at the end we need to save this configuration by using this command copy running config to startup config. It's important, don't forget it. Now close this CLI tab and let's have a ping right now. Just go to the command prompt and ping again and see the results. First we will ping the 10 network, that is the 10.10. which one is 10.10? As you can see, this is for HR computer, HR department computer. So just ping this computer and let's see whether it will ping or not. As we expected, there is no network we are getting from there, and it doesn't reply anything because successfully we have logically grouped our network in a single network. Now let's check the ping of the 10.9 network address, that is the VLAN 3 and this is the IT department. Let's ping. Now here also you can see, as we expected, it doesn't reply anything and it has request timeout message. Now the final check for its own network. Let's check whether it pings their network or not. Now ping to their own group, that is 192.168.10. Let's ping to 5. And as you can see, we are getting the reply from the 10.5 IP address, which is grouped in the accounts department. Now close this PC from here. This is the accounts group. Now let's check with the PDUs message. This is the PDUs message, that means the protocol data unit. Just select this PC and select this one, expand this, and it obvious this will be failed. Now check again to another one, it should be success because it resides within the HR department and HR department can communicate with each other. And now check with again to another department. Now it's success, but HR department can't access the IT department. As you can see, this message showing appears, this is a failed. Now let's check again in the sales department it success. That means the sales department itself within a group, a sales department can ping to each other, but sales department can't ping to HR department or any one department. That means it's logically grouped within a single network. So this is all about the VLAN. So by VLAN we can achieve the logical grouping within a single network. So we don't need to extra switches, extra hubs to grouping a network. So by switch it's possible to grouping a collection of devices within a single network without isolating network types or anything else. Now let's check what are the VLANs configured in our switch and how to see all the VLANs in our switch. So this is a very simple command, just give within your CLI mode by opening the switch, show VLAN brief. By giving this command you will get all the VLAN configured within your switch. So these are all the VLAN, and these are the VLAN which we have assigned manually for each ports. So this is for the accounts department which is active, and these are the ports which belongs to the accounts department VLAN, and this is for the IT, and this is for the HR, and this is for the sales. And thanks for watching my video, and I hope I will get you in the next video.